I am Santosh Gadankar. Today I am teaching you mechanics of material. In that one, stress in the composite section. A structural member composed of two or more elements of different material rigidly connected together at their ends to form a parallel arrangement and subjected to an axial loading in terms is termed as a compound bar. The different material of the member may have the same length or different length. This is the diagram. A load is subjected over the component of same length, I am considering here, rigidly connected together. This is 1 and this is 2, and load is applied. The length is L. It has the same length L. This we call as a composite section. Here, first concept, we have to go for maintaining the equilibrium condition. We have to go for equilibrium condition based upon the diagram. Now first, I will go for free body diagram. Free body diagram of this diagram. The P is acting downward. And these two are restricting upward. P1 and P2. As we know that from the graph, it is positive. I am going to follow this position in order to solve the equilibrium condition. Now, equilibrium condition, first condition is equilibrium. Now, this will be P here, as from the diagram. The P is acting downward. P1 and P2 are acting upward. The upward sign is nothing but positive. P1 is positive. P2 is also positive. Based upon this diagram, minus P, because the P is acting downward, is equal to 0. Now, P1 plus P2 is equal to P. This P further can be written as P1 into A1 plus P2 into A2. That is, stress is equal to P by A. Is equal to P. I will equation as this is a equation 1. Next, I will go for deformations. Now here, in the case of deformation, we are assuming that both the element get deformed at equal amount. Both the material get deformed equal amount. That means delta L1 is always equal to delta L2. If there are three materials, then delta L3 equal, they will deform equally. Now what is the formula for delta L1? P1 L1 divided by A1 E1 is equal to P2 L2 divided by A2 E2. A1 is the area. E is the Young's modulus. And L is the length. P is the load applied. Okay. Now, further, this part we can consider as a sigma 1 L1 divided by E1. Is equal to sigma 2, this part, sigma 2 L2 divided by E2, this is E2. If lengths are equal, you can cancel it out. As per this diagram, L1 is equal to L2, you can cancel it. Next, sigma 1 divided by E1 minus sigma 2 divided by E2 is equal to 0. Write equation 2. Equating 1 and 2, you will get stresses induced in the material. That means you will get sigma 1 value and sigma 2 value. Sigma 1 value and sigma 2 value. Next, elongation. We call it as a net elongation. Delta, any one you can consider. Either you can consider delta L1 or delta L2. I will consider one net. The formula will be P1 P1L1 divided by A1E1. You can substitute, you will get the answer same. If you want to consider for delta L2, you will get the same answer as of that of the delta M1 net value. Now let us consider a problem based upon this concept. This is the problem. A steel rod of cross sectional area 1600 mm square and two brass rod each of cross sectional area of 1000 mm square. The area they have given it. Area of the steel data. Area of the steel is nothing but AS 1600 mm square. Two brass rod each of cross sectional area. Brass, I will consider as a B here. B 1000 mm square. Two brass rod as from the diagram. Okay. Supported a load of 50 kilonewton. 50 kilonewton. P is given as 50 kilonewton. 50 kilonewton. 50 × 10³ newton. This will be P here. As shown in the figure. Find the stresses induced in the rod. We have to find out the stresses in the steel, and we have to find out the stresses in the brass. The Young's modulus of the steel is given as E is equal to 2 × 10⁵ newton per mm square. And Young's modulus for the brass, yes, and this will be 1 × 10⁵ newton per mm square. Also find the load carried by the each rod. That means you have to find out TS load. This is the load, and PB load. And shortening of the length. Shortening of the length. How much it is shortened. That means you can find out delta net. It may be a brass. It may be brass or steel. You have to find out. You have to find out any one. Either brass you can find out or steel you can find out. Now, first I will draw the free body diagram. Free body diagram. From the diagram, from the figure. Now first, the P is acting downward. This is restricted. The P is acting downward from the diagram. I will write P here. P is equal to 50 × 10³ newton. As it is acting downward, it will restrict in opposite direction. I will write this will be PS. Sorry, PB, brass. Exactly at the center, PS, steel. Again, it will be brass. Now, I will use this diagram. Positive, positive, negative, negative. The upward arrow indicates positive sign. I will write here PB plus PS plus PB minus minus P is equal to 0. Further, 2PB plus PS is equal to P. I will bring that side. Next, 2 sigma B AB plus sigma S AS is equal to, what is the value? 50 × 10³. Next, 2 sigma B A brass 1000 plus sigma S steel 1600 is equal to 15 × 10³. This is the equation 1. Now, as per the theory, deformation. Deformation in brass and steel and the brass are equal. Equal. This is for the equilibrium. This is for the equilibrium condition. Now deformation in the member. That means delta LB is equal to delta LS is equal to delta LB. You have to select the combination in such a way that we can find out the deformation. If you select the combination of delta B and delta B, everything will get cancelled. It is better to select the combination of delta B and delta S. Now I will select the combination of delta B and delta S. What is the formula? PB LB divided by AB ES is equal to PS LS divided by AS Yes. I'm considering these two combinations. If you consider these two, everything will get cancelled in order to find out deformation. Now further, this part is nothing but stress. I will write here sigma b ls divided by es. Sorry, it will be b brass, it is for brass. Now the lengths are different here. As per the diagram, the length will, brass length is 200 and the steel will be 200 plus 300. LB is nothing but 200 mm from the diagram, and LS is nothing but 200 plus 300. 100 is nothing but 300 mm. Substitute here, sigma B into LB is nothing but 300, LB, no, it is 200, divided by Young's modulus for brass is 1 into 10 raised to 5. Now I will bring this side, minus sigma s into L is 300, divided by 2 into 10 raised to 5 is equal to 0, equation 2. Equating 192, you will get the answer. Now with the help of the calculator, you can equate it. Phi 1, first is 1000, 1600, 50 into 10 raised to 3, here 200 divided by 1 into 10 raised to 5, minus 300 divided by 2 into 10 raised to 5, 0. Now answer is 15. Where am I? Oh, I have to consider 2 years. I just left a 2 year. 2 into 1000 years. Now see the answer. Now answer is 12. 12, sigma b is equal to 12.09 newton per mm square. Next answer is sigma s is nothing but 16.12 newton per mm square. Okay, here I have left the 2 here. 2 into 1000 you have to do it. It will be 2000. Okay, next, after getting the stresses induced into the material, these are the stresses induced into the material, we have to find out the load. We have to find out the load. What is load? Sigma B is nothing but PB divided by AB. Sigma B is already known, 12.09. AB is nothing but 1000. AB is 1000. The answer will be 12096 newton. That means 12.09 kilonewton. P value. Cross multiply, you will get PB value. Next for sigma s. Sigma s is equal to PS divided by AS. Cross multiply. 16.12 into AS value is 1600, you would get PS value. You can write PS here. PS, the PS will be 12096 newton, and the PB, sorry, PB, PB, not PS, PB. Now PS, multiply it here. The PS will be 25806.4 newton. That means 25.80 kilonewton. What we have to find out again? Shortening in the length of each bar. Either you can consider delta B or delta S. Shortening. shortening of the bar. I will consider here delta S, delta L, delta LS, or you can consider delta LB. You will get the both on same answer. Formula PB LB divided by, I will considering a delta LB here, PB LB divided by what is PB? PB is nothing but 12.09 into 10 raised to 3. What is the length? LB 200 divided by area 1000, Young's modulus 1 into 10 raised to 5. The answer is 0.024 mm. If you consider delta S also, delta LS, you will get the same answer. You will get the same answer. I am Santosh Gadankar. Thank you very much.